Hey, what is happening, guys? Jerma here again with a Team Fortress 2 gameplay commentary. Let's get right into this here. I'm playing as the Eternal Reward Spy. If you are noticing, you're probably saying to yourself, Jerma, Eternal Reward? Holy sheep crap, that's insane. I thought you were terrible with this knife. And I would reply to that, yes, I am actually very bad with this knife, but I happen to get a couple of gameplays in a row on Viaduct. This is not the Halloween event Viaduct. This is normal Viaduct, and it's actually been a while since I've done my last Spy gameplay. Kind of crazy seeing as how last month, I think, is my last Spy gameplay, and I've never done an Eternal Reward gameplay. I did one Eternal Reward gameplay, and it was just me yelling about how I hate the weapon and how I was pissed about it or something. So here is a proper Eternal Reward gameplay, two of them in a row, both of them on Viaduct. And there's something in the middle, something you guys might think is funny, something I just decided to do because I'm an idiot sometimes. The loadout I'm going to be using is the Eternal Reward, obviously, the Cloak and Dagger, and the default Spy Revolver. Gonna tell you what I'm doing right here, just waiting for someone to come out of spawn, someone I can get behind, because right now I'm disguised as an enemy heavy, and they move very slowly, so I want to get a different disguise, don't want to keep the one I have right now. Swinging the knife to get the extra movement speed, and I end up catching up to this medic. That's a quick tip for you. If you are currently disguised as a slow class, do this. Swing the knife when you get close to somebody, and make sure nobody's behind you when you do it, because this is your only means of disguising, so you don't want to give yourself away too quickly. Here comes a face stab right there. That's happened to me, happens to you too. It sucks for all of us. Currently as a soldier right now, and there's nothing I can do about this. That's my biggest complaint about this knife, is the fact that I have to stay a soldier and I have to be a slow bastard, and there's nothing I can do about it besides cloak and run away. So that's why I'm terrible with this knife. I never got good with it. Could never really get the mechanic down. I know a lot of people are really good with this knife, and I give them props. I commend you for being able to play with this knife. Spy standing still disguised as me is always going to die. Trying to help these engineers, I thought he might have been a dead ringer, but it's not the case. We have a flawless victory going right now. They don't stand a chance at all. 3 minutes on our side, less than 15 seconds to go on theirs. I top frag in this gameplay, and I top frag in the second one. So I'm going to do a little transition here. I want to show you this absolutely ridiculous thing that I did. I am so ashamed of it. So we're going to play a game. It's a game show I made up. And it's called...
What a fucking idiot!
Alert. Our control point is being captured.
Absolutely fantastic! John, tell him what he's won!
You've won a free subscription to this diagram. It's only one issue, and it tells you why you're so stupid! What a fucking idiot!
Here we are on the second gameplay, guys. I can't believe I did that. I really don't believe it. When I do things like that, I really surprise myself at how just stupid I can really be. Why would you jump off the... I don't even know. I'm not even going to begin to explain why I did that. So you're probably wondering why this is starting so late. It's because the other team was being spawn camped, and I was literally just sitting there with the cloak and dagger, doing abso-friggin-lutely nothing. So I figured, why not just skip that part? You don't want to see it anyways. It's pretty boring. Managed to get behind everybody here, and I get a couple of stabs. Want the extra speed, so I go after the soldier. What is with the soldiers for me in this gameplay? I seem to only have soldier disguises. Well, we changed that right here, turn into a sniper. Really quickly, want to talk about the knife mechanics. How they're interesting, how they're cool, and why they can work in some situations. Especially when you get yourself into a crowd of people, and you have a disguise already. Sometimes people don't even know what's going on. I've had situations where I've seen an Eternal Reward spy backstab somebody, see them backstab the person, and just my brain explodes. I go, wait, what happened? Who's that? Because your brain is trying to piece together what it's actually seeing. Oh, that's a soldier that just instantly turned into a medic. It's crazy, and it really works sometimes, and some people can put this knife to such good use where they'll turn a corner, backstab the engineer that's next to you. You turn around, see the engineer that's already been there, that's always been there, and then you turn back around and get backstabbed by the same spy. It's a great way to play spy. I, like I said, just am not very good at it. Kind of screwed up right there, but I deceived this sniper enough where I can get the backstab on him. Come up here, I see a scout and I believe a pyro. I get the backstabs on both of them. Then I get killed. There's the one on the scout. There's the one on the pyro. Turn around and a heavy medic pair is right behind me. Get killed by them. Can't get away in time. And that is going to wrap it up here. That's the end of the gameplay. They get overtime, but it doesn't really matter. We still win. Thank you so much, guys. If you like this video, throw me a like. I'll see you all next time. Take care, everybody.